Good morning, students. In this video, I am going to teach you about the fourth civilization, that is the Wang Hu civilization. Earlier, you have seen the videos of this lesson, that is the Mesopotamian civilization and the Egyptian civilization. So today, I am going to teach you Wang Hu civilization, which is also a Chinese civilization. So this civilization took place in the East Asia, in China, around 4,500 years ago. The Chinese civilization is also a river valley civilization, which took place on the river basins of China. The three river basins, which were known as the Yangtze Kiang in the center, the Wanghu in the north, and the Sikiang on the south. Fertile land and the temperate climate made the valley a ideal place for settlement. Chinese civilization developed during the Shang dynasty. The people and the society. The society in China was divided into classes. The emperor or the king and the family held the top position. The nobles, the scholars, the merchants, artisans, craftsmen, and the cultivators form the other classes below the ruling family. The lowest in rank and position in the society were the slaves. They led a miserable life. They were sometimes buried alive along with the master so that they could serve him even after the master's death. The soldiers were a class apart. They were held a high esteem. They had a high importance by the people in the society. People were even afraid of the soldiers. This shows that defense was given high importance in the Chinese civilization. Occupations and crafts. Agriculture was the main occupation of the Chinese people. Agriculture was helped greatly due to the existence of lures of very fine and exceptional fertile soil carried by the rivers through the central plain, making it one of the finest lands for agriculture in the world. So in some less fertile areas, they used manure to increase the productivity of the crops. They had an excellent canal system to control floods. Wheat, rice, millet, soybean and tea were the main crops. Carpentry and wood work were other occupations. Chinese carpenters were famous for cabinet making, timber work in palaces, ivory work on wood, etc. Bronze casting became a large-scale business under the Shang dynasty. Chinese bronze were the product of an advanced technology. Silk production and silk industry was also an occupation of Chinese people. They bred silkworms and made silk out of cocoons. China became the world center of silk production. They exported silk to other countries through silk routes. As the Chinese developed paper, the making of paper became another occupation of the people during this period. Architecture. The Chinese had developed an excellent sense of architectural work. One of the best specimen of this achievement is the Great Wall of China. You can see in the picture that it is shown the Great Wall of China, which is considered as one of the seven wonders of the world. It was built in the 3rd century to ward off, to protect themselves from the attacks of Tatars. Emperor Shi Huangdi built this Great Wall of China as a defense strategy. The Great Wall starts from the Eastern Sea, runs across northern and western frontiers of China and reaches Tibet. Thus, it runs over deserts, mountains and plains. It is said that thousands of workers and slaves took 7 years to complete the structure. Other significant pieces of Chinese architecture are the stupa-type temples, which was known as the pagodas. The inside of a pagoda has beautiful paintings drawn on the walls. Here down you can see a pagoda, Chinese pagoda, which is a traditional part of China, Chinese architecture, and is evolved from the stupa of the Indian subcontinent. The modern pagoda is an evolution of the Indian stupa, a tomb-like structure where sacred relics could be kept safe. What is the meaning of pagoda? A religious building on a sacred tower of pyramidal form. Here you can see a fact file. Marco Polo, a trader from Venice in Italy, visited China during the time of Kublai Khan, a Mongol ruler. He wrote glowing accounts of this highly civilized country. The Mongols invaded and ruled China for a while. They were nomads who lived in the great plains of Central Asia. They were a cruel race which made them very unpopular. They were overthrown by 1300s. The Chinese script is written in upward and down stroke. They wrote on silk cloth or bamboo strips. They used a brush made of camel hair. Thanks to the colorful paints, that their script looked like paintings. Trade and commerce. The Chinese had developed trade relations with the countries like Egypt, Greece, Rome, Iran, India, and other on the Mediterranean Sea. The main items they used to export were tea, silk, and silk products, chinaware, pottery, and paper. Religious beliefs. The Chinese religion is one of the oldest forms of religion. Evidence of the burial practices has been dated to as early as 5000 BCE. So, we have got some of the evidences where they used to bury the dead bodies. Archaeological evidence from Neolithic China shows a remarkable amount of care and ritual with regard to burial practices. So, some characteristics we found from the 5th millennium BCE. That was segregation of dead into what appear to be kingship groupings. Means they used to separate the dead bodies after death into with the blood relationships. That is kinship groupings. Graveside, they used to offer rituals of liquids, pig skulls, and pig jaws. So these were the characteristics which were found in the burial practices. The Chinese were worshippers of nature god, like the people of other civilizations. They regarded the king of China as the son of the heaven god called Shangli. Confucius. Confucius was one of the greatest philosophers of China and also the world. He lived during 551 BC to 479 BC. His teachings have a universal appeal. These are popular all over the world, and the philosophy and the religion advocated by Confucius is known as Confucianism. His main teachings were, the first, Confucius believed in humility towards all. You should behave kindly with everyone. Second, he taught, do unto others as you wish others to do unto you. So, as you wish that others should help you, in the same way, you should also help others. He taught that admission of one's error is a great virtue. He who errs and does not admit errs twice was his principle. That means he thought that you should accept the mistake it is a great virtue. And the person who doesn't accept the first mistake, he will again do the mistake twice. He taught his followers to respect the elders and ancestors. He taught that you should respect the elders and ancestors. Okay, now science and technology. The Chinese made a remarkable advancement in astronomy. They counted that there were 365 days and 12 months in a year. They even devised a big astronomical clock. They used lunar and solar calendars also. They could also predict eclipse. They could also tell about the eclipses. They also developed a system to keep a record of weather, climate, rainfall, drought, floods, etc. The Chinese even invented the seismograph. Seismograph is an instrument which predicts the earthquakes which takes place in the areas. Other inventions made by Chinese included mariner compass, the umbrella, the paper and gunpowder. They were also the first to invent writing with ink. They introduced banking and paper currencies first among all. So children, you understood this civilization, Chinese civilization. So in this chapter, you have studied three civilizations. That is the Mesopotamian civilization, the Egyptian civilization and the Wang Hu civilization. In the first chapter, you have studied about the Indus Valley civilization. Hope you all understood the lesson. Thank you, children.